The stars blink silently, a full moon glows above, and a hush has fallen across the land. But upstairs in this house, a small boy is busy building a castle in his room. For many people with autism, as for this boy, a good night's sleep is an elusive thing. As much as 86% of children on the spectrum experience disrupted sleep, which can leave them feeling out of sync with the rest of the world. Some autistic people have trouble falling asleep, taking an average of 11 minutes longer than a neurotypical person does. Others wake periodically throughout the night, or rise hours earlier than anyone else. Many people with autism also spend less time in the rapid eye movement, or REM, sleep stage, which is crucial for learning and consolidating memories. Sleeplessness harms anyone who experiences it. In autistic people, it amplifies several traits, including hyperactivity and repetitive behaviors. What causes the sleep problems in autistic people? To begin with, many common autism traits directly affect sleep. Anxiety and attention deficit hyperactivity disorder can make it difficult for a person to relax enough to slip into a peaceful slumber. Gastrointestinal problems such as constipation, diarrhea, and acid reflux, noise and light sensitivity, and seizures can all interrupt restful sleep. People with autism also have a higher incidence of sleep apnea, a condition that causes breathing to start and stop erratically. Research shows that some autistic people have mutations in genes involved in the circadian clock, which controls our sleep-wake cycle, and some children on the spectrum produce irregular amounts of the sleep hormone melatonin at night. This might make them feel awake when they should feel sleepy, or make it difficult to judge when it's time to get up. With such variable causes, treating sleeplessness in autistic people is a huge challenge. That's complicated by the fact that it's difficult to disentangle the effects of autism on sleep, and vice versa. Sleep research is crucial, but for decades, it has taken a backseat to other aspects of autism research. That may be changing, however, as researchers start to see poor sleep not only as a side effect of autism, as a hallmark of the condition. While researchers try to unravel sleep's mysteries, there are steps autistic people can take to alleviate their sleep problems. Exercising during the day, limiting exposure to noise and digital screens before bed, building a routine around sleep, and having a consistent bedtime are all associated with improvements to the quality of slumber. Drugs such as slow-release melatonin may also streamline sleep cycles in some people with autism. These refined sleeping habits may enhance attention and foster better social interactions, improving the overall quality of life for people on the spectrum and helping them get the rest they need to face the day.